Hello friends, in the previous video, that is the financial statement analysis part 1, we have seen that what exactly financial statement analysis means, which all statements need to be analyzed to have an overall view of the financial position of a company, and we have as well seen that who all are the analysts, who all are the stakeholders. They need to analyze the financial position of a company. We have seen that from investor's point of view, from money lender's point of view, from the owner's or manager's point of view, as well as the suppliers, that is the creditors, and the employee's point of view, that why each of them needs to analyze the financial position of a company. Now let us understand in this video, that is what to look for. In the previous video, we have started this, but due to some technical issue, we had to close down that video at some point in between. But in this video, we'll continue the same part, as in what exactly we need to look at to analyze the financial position of a company. So whenever, friends, remember, whenever you have financial statements of any company to be analyzed, you should look at. If you want an overall analysis of the company, you should look for these five elements into it. When you're analyzing the company, you need to look at these five aspects of the financial statements. The first aspect that one needs to look at, that is the liquidity. Friends, let me tell you, 95% of the organizations that fall sick or the organizations that fail, they do not fail due to lack of assets, they do not fail due to lack of profits, but majority of the organizations that fail, they are failing due to lack of liquidity. Yes, friends, a very, very, very crucial aspect in the life of an organization is managing liquidity. The most difficult task for any finance manager is managing for liquidity. What exactly this liquidity means? This liquidity is nothing but the ability of the organization to pay off the short-term debts. Yes, it is the ability of an organization to pay away these short-term debts. In simple terms, this liquidity element, it tries and analyzes that whether the current assets with the organization are sufficient enough to fulfill and to pay off all the current liabilities of the organization. So liquidity, it talks of analyzing the liquidity position, that is the short-term liquidity, the short-term ability to pay off the short-term liabilities. That is given to us, that needs to be analyzed, because that is the very first test. If an organization is unable to fulfill its short-term liabilities, there are bright chances that the organization would also fail in the long run to fulfill its long-term liabilities. So having a good liquidity position for a company is really, really very crucial. So first you should analyze the liquidity position of a company. This should be followed by the profitability of the organization. Yes, because the long-term sustainability of the organization is denoted or can be guaranteed only if an organization is making consistent profits. So once you have analyzed the liquidity of the company, then you should go and analyze the profitability. How well is the organization making profits? What is the tune of profits? What is the consistency in making profits? Or is it only by fluke that in a year the company is making good profits and not in all the years? So profitability is one of the major parameters that one should look at. Once you see that the organization is making profits, then the most important factor for long-term sustainability and overall performance of the organization, it comes from the third element, that is the efficiency, also called as the turnover part of it. When we say efficiency, what exactly efficiency is? The efficiency element tells us that how well the company is managing its assets and what amount of output is generated with the given input. So in other terms, you can say that how well an organization is using its resources. Now, the resource can be machinery, resource can be materials, resource can be money, resource can be fixed assets, resource can be total assets. How well these resources are used to convert the inputs into maximum amount of output. How many times the inputs are getting converted into output. That is the efficiency. Now, here you will analyze how long is the operating cycle, how, what is the creditors, the credit terms with your creditors as well as with your debtors, that means the suppliers and your customers. All that is a part of the efficiency analysis. Followed by the efficiency, now would be followed by the leverage part of it, or you can say the capital structure part of it. The capital structure is nothing but the mix of debt and equity capital sources in the organization. It is very important that an organization has a just or a rational proportion, an optimal mix of the debt and equity capital in the organization. An organization having excessive of debt may lead to bankruptcy if they default in payment of interest and principal. So, an organization having larger amount of debt has got greater amount of risk, and so ultimately the cost of equity will as well increase. On the other hand, an organization having greater amount of equity and very lesser debt will ultimately lead to paying excessive cost of capital, because as we know that the cost of equity capital is always higher than the cost of debt. The cost of equity capital is always higher, greater than the cost of debt. So neither of the two situations, neither of it, the debt or the equity, should be in excess. But instead, the organization to try and maintain an optimal mix of the debt and equity capital into it. This was the fourth element. Now, once you have analyzed these four internal parameters of the company, then you should move towards the market-related parameters. Now, what are these market-related parameters? These parameters tell us about the trust the investors are having in the organization. How well trusted your organization is. Are the investors really keen to invest in the organization? What is the earning per share? What is the return on equity that the organization is generating for its equity shareholders? What is the price earning ratio? So in a way, these are the parameters that take into consideration not just the internal performance, but also the external performance, the secondary market performance, the performance of the organization in the actual stock markets, in the actual capital markets. Because that is the perception of the investors about the company. So, when you are looking at the big picture, if you consider all these five parameters for analyzing the organization, analyzing the financial statements of the organization, and by analyzing these five parameters will give you a true picture about the organization. It will tell you in detail about the liquidity, profitability, efficiency, the leverage, and as well the market performance of the organization. If you analyze any organization from all these five parameters, I guarantee you that you will have a great understanding about the overall financial position of the organization and financial status of the organization, and you yourself as an investor, as a money lender, as a creditor, or as an employee, or maybe the owner of the business, you would be in a great position to take any decisions regarding the organization. Now, what are the techniques that can be used to analyze the financial statements of the organization? Friends, there are multiple techniques that can be used to analyze the financial statements. Now, in our upcoming videos, we are going to see different techniques that can be used to analyze the financial statements. And we'll start with the first one, that is the ratio analysis. What exactly the ratios are and how they are used to analyze the financial statements. So please subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for my upcoming videos on financial statement analysis. Thank you.